Hi, this is a demonstration of student faculty document sharing system. So this is a smart Android based system that allows students and faculties to interact and share documents with each other. So here the faculty or the university professors, teachers can share documents to students easily. It may be exam timetables or, you know, assignments, notices, anything in image as well as text format. So the faculties can operate from a web-based application while the students can use this Android application. So faculties may upload using the web application and students here can see all those categories, and the student can just download document which is required for that student. Suppose student belongs to a particular class, so he can only download the notices, assignments and material which he is required to download. He cannot access other resources. Even the faculties may post upload documents which they are, you know, needed to download.
So let's see how the system works. So this is credits module where you can add the name of your teacher, your partners and all, and you can mention all your works. Next is login module. So you have to log in with your student ID and your password. So that's my password and I will say login. So you can see that there's a star mark near semester 3. So whenever a new book is uploaded by the student, uploaded by the teacher, you can see the star mark, and when you go inside that, you can see all your books for your particular semester. So let's click on this a.pdf and this will get downloaded. So let's just wait, and you can you will get the option for download, and you can see that your file was downloaded and you can open that file. So let's see the file. So this is the file uploaded by the teacher, and I can view it in my phone itself. So this is the list of all the files, the results or any notices provided by the admin or the teacher, and we'll get your files over here. So you can see that the star mark has been gone as we have viewed all the files. So next is take test module, where you will be provided by some random questions and you can just fill the questions and get your test result. So I will just randomly select any options and will show you how the test works. So let's answer for this one and for this file. Next I will answer this. Same way, you can just fill all the questions and that will be shown to you at the end of this test. And the final one, and I will say submit. So you can see that you have been provided with your score for the test. Now I will just log out and let's see the admin module, how it works. So this is my admin module or the admin panel. So I will just log in into it with my provided ID and the password. So that's my admin ID and my password. This will allow me to access the admin panel. So rights which admin has is as students. So I just click on that and we'll add student from there. So you have to enter the name of the student and the ID will be auto generated. So the name of the student, say ABC, the semester of that student, so his semester is 3, and the mobile number of that particular student, that's the phone number, and then you say add. It will register that student to the database. And next we have is upload books module, where you can upload a book for a particular semester. So first you have to select the semester and then you have to choose your PDF file of that particular book. So I will say choose file and I will select my book Now it's open, and then just click on OK to upload that particular file. So my file has been uploaded, and its entry has been made into the database, and you can see that it says file uploaded successfully. Next we have is view book module, where you can see the uploaded books. So if you want to select a book for a particular semester, you can just select a semester from that drop down and select search. So this is my new file which I uploaded recently. And next is add questions module. So the questions which you add from here will be added to the students take a test module. So I can select the semester of that question. Then I will enter my question. So, and you have to enter the four options over there, and you have to enter the correct answer and say add. For semester 3 we have already added 10 questions, so it won't take that question again. So we have to enter for some other semester. So you can select some other question, some other semester, and add an idea question, and it will be added to the database. So only 10 questions per semester. So next is view questions module, where you can see the semester question ID, question, its options and its correct options. So these are the 10 questions for my semester 3. If I want, I can add new questions in some other semesters. So I'll say log out, and this is how the system works. Thank you.